Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our first pay-per-view event of the year. It is here once and for all. It is Extreme Rules, and I could not be more excited for tonight's matchups here in Cincinnati, Ohio. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen, kicking off Extreme Rules with a tag team competition. All matches here tonight will be Extreme Rules, therefore anything will go. This matchup here is a tornado tag team matchup. Extreme Rules, of course, World Class versus Shrek and Barney. These two have been going back and forth on Raw over the last couple weeks, and once and for all, we will get to see who the best team really is. Quite an interesting duo here, Shrek and Barney. They've been competing on Monday Night Raw together. They are hungry tonight, maybe looking for a tag team championship opportunity against whoever can win that matchup tonight between the Industry and Mike Squared. So we are all set to get started here in our first matchup of the night. It is Extreme Rules. It is here once and for all. Let's do it. Ring the bell, and there they go. So tornado tag team action. No tags are required here tonight. This match will end in a pinfall or submission. There's no other way that we could have a victor here tonight. So far, Barney and Shrek look to be in control, but World Class coming alive now. You see Lionel Messi working on Barney. Kobe Bryant working on Shrek. Remember, Kobe and Shrek had a one-on-one match last week on Raw, in which Kobe was the victor. Shrek and Barney do have a tag team victory over World Class already, but obviously the stakes a little bit higher tonight in this Extreme Rules tornado tag team matchup. And look at Messi! Diving, flying shoulder. So it appears that Messi is in control for World Class. And now Kobe's starting to get in control here as well, and now looking for a weapon. The Black Mamba searching for a weapon. He's got a kendo stick. Kobe Bryant looking to hit Shrek with the stick, but Shrek grabs it. Looking to wail away here, and a shot to the crown. So the first weapon of the night is a kendo stick. Bouncing right off of Kobe's head. And it might be Ogre. One, two. A kick out at two from Shrek. Or I'm sorry, from Kobe. Shrek with the cover there. Messi working on Barney outside. In complete control of that situation, but he's got to watch out here. His partner is in danger inside the ring. And now Messi goes flying right next to our announce table here. Knee drop to the face by Barney. Running neck breaker by Kobe. And now Barney's got a chair. Oh my God. Barney with a huge shot to Messi. And what is Shrek looking for here? Oh my God! rubbing his disgusting hiney in the face of Kobe Bryant. That is awful. But Kobe now looking to get back into this match. Sending the back of Shrek's head off of his knee. Diving shoulder block and another one here. And Kobe Bryant getting fired up. And what is he going to look for here? Can he get him? Shrek reverses it. Huge reversal there from Shrek. Messi still pounding away on Barney. On the outside here, Kobe's looking for a cover. Two. And a kick out at two from the Ogre. So it seems as though World Class here in control of this matchup, but Shrek with a gut-wrench suplex. What a maneuver there. A knee to the head. Irish whip into the corner by Kobe. Thrusting his shoulder into Shrek's midsection here. Messi with a snap suplex here on the outside. So Lionel Messi here, very impressive so far in this match. Completely controlling Barney here. He's got to watch out, like I said. His partner could be in danger here. And it looks like Shrek's going to go for this again. This disturbing maneuver. Oh my god. And he's going to go for a cover here. Can he get him? Two. Kick out at two from Kobe. So far here, no team really taking full control of this match. Now Barney has brought Messi back into the ring. All four members here back inside the ring. And Barney using some strength there, sending Messi to the mat. Double Irish whips here, opposite teams. And now Shrek, what is he looking for here? Huge power bomb, and he's gonna go for a cover. Barney's going for the Dinosaur Express in the corner. Barney hits the Dinosaur Express, but deciding not to go for a cover here as his partner is working on Kobe, and now he's gonna go for cover. Shrek already celebrating. But it was too late. Messi is out. I think he would have had him there if he would have just went for a cover sooner. Almost as if he was waiting for Shrek to maybe do something there. But a huge clothesline from Messi, and now it looks like World Class back in control here. Now, Kobe climbing to the top rope here. What's he going to look for? Good. Cross body, but he's caught. And Shrek. Oh my god. And now Shrek going after Messi. What a counter from Shrek. So what a match we have here to open up the night. And now Shrek, what is he doing? Oh my god. And a huge superplex backdrop from Shrek. But Barney, inadvertently, with a right hook to his partner's face. Shrek is slow to get up, but now gonna try and go for cover here. One, two, double cover. Barney here, got a two count on Kobe. And it's over. So Kobe Bryant, after getting caught trying to go for a diving crossbody, got hit with a huge Death Valley driver there. And that was enough. Barney was able to get the cover. Well, it seemed like World Class might have had more control over this match. In the end, it is Shrek and Barney picking up another victory here over the Athletes. So impressive victory here. And we will see later on tonight who our tag team champions are going to be tomorrow night on Raw. And will Shrek and Barney look to make a statement tomorrow? We will have to wait and see. See the two beasts congratulating each other in the center of the ring here. What a victory to kick off Extreme Rules. Next up is our number one contenders match for the United States Championship, Spider-Man and Harambe. So next up here, we have our number one contenders match for the United States Championship. Spider-Man and Harambe, each of these men earning a win last week on Raw to get themselves into this position. Of course, the current champion, Rick Ross, not in action here tonight, so when will we see his first title defense? Here comes Harambe. Harambe was in the first main event of our first Raw, facing off with Bane, a man who was a match away from getting a shot at the Universal Championship, but very impressive showing from Harambe in that matchup, and now he will get an opportunity to compete against Spider-Man for a chance at the United States Championship. So here we go. And as I mentioned, all matches tonight are Extreme Rules competitions. Anything will go here tonight. We see Harambe start with a big fall away slam, a silverback gorilla. Against the man spider. Spider-Man going on the offensive here, stomping away at Harambe, but Harambe gonna counter. Now a jawbreaker here. These two competitors going back and forth so far, and Spider-Man with a huge kick to the throat. Almost took Harambe's head off for the second time. And now Spider-Man, maybe looking for a Spidey splash earlier. No, he's going to look for a corkscrew and he hits it. What a maneuver, but Harambe back here with a big flip, sending Spider-Man crashing down to the mat. And throwing him down, his head bouncing off the canvas. But there's a big knee to the face. Counter there by Spider-Man, looking to get back into this match. And go for a suplex here, and he's gonna hit it. And now going back up to the top. And a diving elbow this time. So a couple of diving maneuvers here. We've not seen the Spidey splash yet, but the high-flying antics of Spider-Man on show here tonight. But now Harambe pinching at the nerve in Spider-Man's neck. Now Irish whip onto the apron and he's sent to the ground. And now Spider-Man back up top for a third time. And he's gonna miss. I think he broke his coccyx. But he's up and he's back. Harambe looking for a weapon here. Looking for that military press that we saw him use on Bane. Countered here from Spider-Man. Kicks to the leg. Now dragging Harambe to our announce table here. What's he gonna look for? Sending his head right off the table. And now back into the ring they go. But Harambe, Irish whip into the corner. And a huge maneuver there, thrusting himself into Spider-Man. And he's gonna go for cover. One, two. A kick out at two from Spider-Man. Now attacking the nerve. And Harambe gonna go back outside here. Is he gonna look for a weapon? And he will. What's he gonna find? He has a baseball bat. And he gets the ref with it. What the hell was that? Harambe attacking the ref. And now, gonna look for a power bomb, but it's countered. And it looks like both men are hurt. So Spider-Man countered that power bomb, but both men hurt, both slow to get up here. And Harambe back to his feet. Spider-Man trying to roll out of the way. Just playing with Spider-Man like he's a four-year-old. Going for a cover. One, two. Kick out at two. And Harambe looks a little bit rattled here. Will he look for the sharpshooter? He's able to lock in the sharpshooter on Bane two times in their matchup at the beginning of the month, but is not able to pick up a victory. A Russian leg sweep from Spider-Man. Now staring at the motionless gorilla Harambe. And is he going to look for it here? He stared him down. And a Spidey splash. But Harambe rolls out of the way. So just in the nick of time, Harambe getting out of the way of a Spidey splash. Now back on the attack here, but Spider-Man gonna counter a flying forearm. Huge flying forearm, and is he gonna look for it again? Spider-Man flying, and he hits it. Spidey splash from Spider-Man, gonna go for a cover here. One, two, three. Spider-Man is your new number one contender for the United States Championship. So what a showcase here from Spider-Man, showing off his high-flying ability. And ultimately putting away Harambe with a Spidey splash. So we will have to wait and see when Rick Ross will put his championship on the line against Spider-Man. But as for right now, Spider-Man, very happy to pick up that victory here in Cincinnati at Extreme Rules. So what a victory it was there for Spider-Man, picking up a win over Harambe. But next up, we have our first title match of the night. It is Mike Squared challenging the tag team champions, The Industry. So it is time here for our first title match of the night as we watch that electrifying entrance here by Mike Squared. The champions. So this is actually the first time here since week one that we will see the Industry in action. In week one, they faced off with their opponents tonight, Mike Squared, and Mike Squared picked up a victory in that one. And ever since then, it had been known that they would be getting a shot at the Industry's championships, but they look very ready here tonight. Drake and Lil Wayne, very ready to keep those championship belts inside of the Industry. So Mike Squared looking on. Very interesting combination of Mike Myers and Michael Jackson, but they have made it work and looked very, very impressive as a team together. And then, of course, our champions here, the industry. Rick Ross, also part of the industry. He holds a belt. Nicki Minaj, part of the industry, will have an opportunity at a belt tonight. But for right now, these two, Drake and Lil Wayne, looking to defend their championships. And that's what it's all about here tonight. Opportunity at tag team immortality. And here they go, tornado tag action, extreme rules. And right away, we see Mike Myers doing what he does best on this team, and that is be an absolute destroyer. A Lil Wayne working on Michael Jackson. Mike with a huge Hurricane Rana there. Mike Jackson, I should say. Drake, look at the spine buster there. On the monster of a man that is Michael Myers. And now Drake, not wasting any time. He knows that a weapon was probably going to be his best bet here against Mike Myers. And we have our first table of the night. So Drake here has gotten a table out, working on Michael Myers on the outside of the ring, and a flapjack sending his face bouncing off the wood on the table. I don't think it was cracked. As we see Michael Myers here in control, but Michael Jackson with a moonsault off the top rope there, and another one, but he's going to miss. After hitting one, Lil Wayne rolls out of the way of another. But look at the athleticism here. Michael Jackson. So Drake has Mike Myers locked up on the outside. But Michael Jackson is in control inside the ring here with Lil Wayne, but a Hurricane Rana there. He's going to go for a quick cover. One, two, kick out at two. So the table still sits, but now Mike Myers is going to grab it. He's going to use it as a weapon here, choosing not to set it up, and Drake counters that. See a brain buster on the inside of the ring. And now all four men are in the ring here. Michael Jackson screaming for Lil Wayne to get up. And it's going to be a counter into a powerbomb. What a move there from Lil Wayne. And he's going to go for a cover. Two. Michael Jackson, no kicking out of that. Drake is going to look for a dancing elbow drop here. So it looks like the champions are in control here. As Lil Wayne looking for a superplex from the top rope. Can he get it? And look at that impact. And now going to go back to the second rope. But Drake looking for a cover in the meantime here. Got a two count, and it's over. So Lil Wayne hitting a giant superplex on Michael Jackson, taking him out of the match essentially, and allowing Drake to work on the behemoth. And we saw him hit that dancing elbow, signature maneuver from Drake. And then the Six God. And that was enough to do it. So the champions here retaining their belts here at Extreme Rules. And the industry still has an opportunity to go 4-for-4 in terms of championships. We'll see how Nicki Minaj performs tonight against someone that she's already beaten. Well, right now I'm getting word that something is breaking out backstage. Let's jump back and see what's going on. Oh my God! Bane is assaulting Goku in the back here. What the hell is this? A suplex here. So clearly Bane is unhappy about missing out on some action here at Extreme Rules and choosing to take it out on the man who has been colliding with Dr. Doom over the past 4 weeks. Dr. Doom, of course, is the one who took the opportunity away from Bane to go for the Universal Championship. I don't know why he's choosing to attack Goku here tonight, but Goku throwing Bane into a door, and they are inside of the locker room here. So after Bane had apparently assaulted Goku, jumped him from behind, now Goku's starting to fight back here. These two superstars have been two of the most prevalent that we have had so far here. Neither of them were given a match here tonight, but they are going at it here in the backstage. And Goku here. But Bane with a gut-wrench suplex. Now tossing Goku into the door frame, sending his head bouncing off the steel. But an elbow shot to the face here, and a huge right hook. And now throwing Bane into the same frame. These two superstars clearly upset here tonight. I don't think Goku is expecting anything like this, but he will not back down after being assaulted, after being jumped by Bane. And now look at this. Look at this. Move into this backstage area here, and Bane with a huge power bomb, and he's not done. Oh my God, look at this power. Goku might be unconscious. We're going to be keeping a close eye on Goku's condition as the night goes forward, but now it is time for our Intercontinental Championship match. After watching that assault from Goku, Bane ambushing Goku in the back for no apparent reason whatsoever other than just being angry at a man who I guess he viewed as a prime target given his status here on Raw. Gotta cut back to action though. get back on track here tonight as we move into our Intercontinental title match. So Deadpool here, after earning an opportunity by winning a six-man battle royal, he then faced off with Ash 6 days ago on Raw and lost, despite the fact that he had grabbed the rope during the pinfall. But tonight, that does not matter to him. He has an opportunity at a championship here and one of the most prestigious, the Intercontinental Championship. And here comes our champion, coming off a massive victory on Raw last week against the Universal Champion. So Skeletor clearly has all of the momentum, all of the confidence heading into this match, his first title defense here in an Extreme Rules contest. I think this is going to be a great matchup here as you see our Intercontinental Championship on the line tonight for the first time. So we see Deadpool. He is ready. He has been waiting for this opportunity on a huge scale here at Extreme Rules, our first pay-per-view event. And then none other than our champion here, Skeletor. He is not ready for his title reign to be over, I can tell you that. Giving the title to the referee here. Deadpool takes a good look. We are just about ready to get started here in Cincinnati, Ohio. So with the championship on the line, the bell has rang, and here we go, and Skeletor is not going to waste any time here tonight. Instantly going outside and grabbing a steel chair. But Deadpool, not going to deal with that quite yet, getting outside, stopping that attempt by Skeletor to bring some weapons into this match. Of course, that's perfectly legal. The champion cannot be disqualified. He cannot retain his championship via disqualification. And now Deadpool, big drop kick on the outside. So Deadpool survived five other men to earn this opportunity. Five great superstars here on Raw. And looking good so far against the champ. But Skeletor back in here. But there we go. Deadpool with a flip. sending Skeletor crashing down on that thinly padded floor here around the ring. And now Deadpool gonna look for a weapon, and he's got a kendo stick. Now Skeletor grabbing another chair from under the ring, and once again Deadpool gonna block an attempt at a chair shot, but Skeletor with a backbreaker. So despite a few attempts here, no weapons have been used, but Skeletor using the turnbuckle post as a weapon, throwing Deadpool's face right off that steel, but apparently not very fazed by it, because Deadpool right back in this with a leg drop on the champ, and another one. Actually gonna drop the knee there instead. But now Skeletor with some uppercuts and a big DDT on the outside. So these superstars favoring the outside here, looking to inflict some pain, using what is around the ring, the barricade, maybe the turnbuckle post, but there's a miss there from Skeletor. We saw him use that on Darth Maul. Might have played a huge part in his victory. Some might have even considered that an illegal maneuver in their matchup on Raw, which was not no disqualification. Of course, tonight no one's going to question it. But Deadpool with an elbow. Now looking to get back in here. But Skeletor once again throwing Deadpool's face off that turnbuckle post. And I think Deadpool is badly hurt here. And Skeletor, huge club to the face, and Deadpool's head is taking a beating so far in this matchup, and now looking to get back into the ring. The right hook, but Deadpool gonna look to get back in this here. Deadpool with a huge flapjack, and there is the drop, elbow drop with the kip up. We've seen him utilize that signature Deadpool here. But despite that, Skeletor is right back into this thing. Maybe looking for a Havoc Staff here. Looks like he's setting up, but Deadpool gonna counter. And Deadpool going on the attack here. Gonna go for cover. 1, 2, kick out at 2. So what a match from these two so far tonight. Intercontinental Championship on the line. And Skeletor might have it here. 1, 2, kick out at 2. The fans here in Cincinnati going crazy for these two competitors. And a huge inverted DDT into his knee, and another elbow drop here, and Deadpool getting these fans riled up once again. That kip up and a little bit of showboating. No other way that Deadpool knows how to do things. But look at this. Huge face buster. And now Skeletor getting fired up here. Gonna go for a chop, but that's blocked. And now Deadpool setting up for a power bomb into a cover. 1, 2, and into a submission hold here. But Skeletor's gonna roll out. And now Deadpool, maybe going to go for one of those weapons, decides against it. Maybe thinks he has him here if he tries again. Two. And a kick out at two. Deadpool looking a little frustrated here. Now Skeletor back on the attack, going for a quick cover here. Two. Kick out at two. Skeletor getting fired up here tonight. Looking to defend his championship. And he is going to look for it here. Havoc Staff. Cover. One. Two. Oh my God! Oh my God! Deadpool kicks out at 2.5. Unbelievable here. And I don't think Skeletor believes it either. He is going to go to the top rope. Perching on the top turnbuckle here, waiting for Deadpool to get up. And a jumping double axe handle. Will he go for a cover? And Skeletor here. Some huge shots, but Deadpool trying to get back into things. Skeletor not going to allow that to happen. Chops across the chest and an uppercut. Now a right hook. Skeletor utilizing these strikes very effectively here. So after kicking out of a Havoc Staff, Deadpool looking a little disoriented, not able to get himself back into this match, but here we go here. Deadpool getting fired up and sending Skeletor to the mat. Is he going to look for a curb stomp? Jumping elbow drop and a kip up. Getting these fans fired up. Can he do it here? Looked like he might have been setting him up for it, but a counter by Skeletor. And now a German suplex. A German suplex from the champ. And Deadpool was looking to be in some trouble there, but able to counter it. And now setting Skeletor up. What's he going to look for here? Bronco Buster there from Deadpool. And a jumping leg drop. Getting Skeletor to his feet. Kick to the midsection. But Skeletor was looking for a cutter, it looked like, and got thrown off. And now these two standing, staring one another down, wondering what the hell is it going to take here to put each other away. And now Skeletor gonna go, and he's gonna go for cover here. One, two, and a kick out. Back and forth they go. Deadpool will not quit here in this match. He knows how important this opportunity is. Another cover. Two. Gets the shoulder up. Skeletor looking a little bit shocked here that Deadpool is still around in this matchup. And now gonna go for a weapon. And he's not messing around here. Skeletor gets a ladder. Using it. Attacking Deadpool's head. And now into the spine. Over and over again with these shots. Merciless from Skeletor. And I don't think Deadpool is going to be around much longer. After eating all that steel, but a DDT out of nowhere. Oh my god, what is it going to take? What is it going to take for Deadpool to get knocked out of this matchup? And here we go. Deadpool getting fired up. But Skeletor once again with a counter. Deadpool not able to set up for that curb stomp and a Havoc Staff. And the champ. 1, 2, 3. The champion retains here tonight. In an absolutely incredible match, and Deadpool with a very impressive performance here in his first title matchup. It took everything that Skeletor had to put Deadpool away in this match. And ultimately, the second Havoc Staff put him away. Champion retains here tonight. What a match. But Skeletor is still your Intercontinental Champion. Next up, a match that we have been waiting for a very long time. Finally, Harley Quinn will put her Women's Championship on the line against Nicki Minaj, who looks to bring another championship into the industry. So here we go, our co-main event of the night. A match that has been very, very anticipated since the very first week when Nicki Minaj defeated the champion Harley Quinn in a non-title matchup. And now, with an opportunity to take that belt and add a fourth championship into the industry. Comes the champion herself, Harley Quinn. So since that loss, Harley Quinn has not let up. She had a big win over Catwoman. Now tonight, she looks for her first title defense against Nicki Minaj. So we are just about set here. Women's Championship. Very prestigious championship here on Raw. It is on the line here tonight between two of this division's top superstars. And here we go. I have been waiting for this match since week one, and it is finally here. And who is it gonna be? Extreme Rules action here tonight in the women's division. And Nikki starting off here. But looks like Harley Quinn not wasting any time. Huge uppercut there. And the champion starting out strong, looking for a vertical suplex, but it's countered. And Nicki Minaj hits one of her own. And now here she goes. Looking for a weapon, but Harley is not going to allow that right now, but sent off the stairs. So Nicki Minaj here, looking for a weapon. She knows that that might be her best friend here tonight in this title match, where anything goes, but popped up and sent down onto the thinly padded cement floor. And the champion has been hungry for revenge. A lot of people were talking after that week one loss. A lot of people believed that Harley was not fit to start out this new universe mode as the champion. And she looks to silence all of those critics here tonight. But Nicki Minaj is pulling out a ladder. And Harley's going to grab it. And there it is. So after Nicki gets it out, Harley Quinn using it as a weapon. But Nicki right back into things here. Going for a drop kick there. Harley gets out of the way. A headbutt there from the champion. Hopefully we do not see any interference here tonight from either Drake, Lil Wayne, or Rick Ross, as we see Nicki Minaj send Harley Quinn off the steps. Now a huge leg drop on the apron, crushing the throat of Nicki Minaj, and now a spine buster. And we saw her use that spine buster against Catwoman. And now is she gonna look? The PLP, and she gets it. PLP from Harley Quinn, going for a cover. One, two, oh my god, no! It looked as though the ref's hand had hit the mat, but 2 7/8. Unbelievable, and another cover here. This might do it. Kick out at 2. I still cannot believe how close that was. Harley Quinn with the PLP on the challenger, and she powers out at the very last split second. And Harley, another cover here. I don't think she can believe that the challenger is still in this. So Nicki Minaj looking to work her way back into this match. She might have Harley a little bit rattled here. And there's a big snake eye sending Harley's head off the turnbuckle in a backbreaker. And now Nikki looking to go to the top rope here. Nicki Minaj with a diving elbow. Huge elbow drop there. One, two, kick out at two from the champ. So thus far, this match is living up to the hype. What is it going to take for one of these women to put away the other and walk out of here with the Women's Championship? As we see Nicki Minaj dropping an elbow on the spine. But now Harley looking to get back in. Irish whip into the corner. But Nicki counters with an elbow. Now going back and forth here. And Harley Quinn setting up for a big scoop slam into a throw. Going for a cover here, too. Kick out at two. So now the champ looking for some momentum here. And a spine buster from the champion. Is that going to do it? One, two, three. So Harley Quinn is still your women's champion, and the industry will have to wait on its 4-for-4 championship lineup. We see the PLP that Nicki Minaj kicked out of at the very last second. But then it was that signature spinebuster from Harley Quinn that put away the challenger here. And what a victory. So Nicki Minaj not quite able to grab that title here tonight, but looking very, very impressive. But tonight it's all about Harley Quinn retaining her women's championship here at Extreme Rules. What a night has been up to this point. We have seen some excellent Extreme Rules contests tonight, but one thing that we have not seen is a title change hands. Will that change here in our main event of the night for the biggest prize of them all, the Universal Championship? We have Dr. Doom facing off with the champ, Darth Maul, here in Cincinnati, Ohio. So here we go with our main event of the night. Be Dr. Doom that walks away as Universal Champion here tonight, or will it be our champion Darth Maul? So here we go. We are ready. I've got chills. I'm not going to lie. This is going to be a huge main event here tonight. One that we have been waiting for. The Universal Championship is on the line between Dr. Doom, the challenger who defeated Bane in a number one contenders match to earn this opportunity. He's been going back and forth with Goku over the past few weeks. He is facing off with a man who just returned here 2 weeks ago, confronting Bane, and then last week with a matchup against the Intercontinental Champion Skeletor, a match in which he lost, but I'm sure he's put that out of his mind with this belt on the line here tonight. Relinquishing it for the time being. Will he be able to walk out of here? Or will it be Dr. Doom? So here we go. The Universal title is on the line, and Dr. Doom starting out here with a huge Irish whip and going right after the champion, not wasting any time here. And now showing these fans that he means business here tonight. But here comes Darth Maul, but no, and there's a counter. Into an arm drag, but Maul with a trip. Into a Boston Crab here. Locking up an early submission maneuver. Dr. Doom gonna roll out of that. So Dr. Doom had that Extreme Rules match against Goku, in which he took an incredible amount of punishment. You gotta wonder if he is even 100% yet after that matchup. It was 2 weeks ago, but I'm not sure if he will be. But so far, looking to be in great shape here against the champ, and an Irish whip into that exposed turnbuckle. Darth Maul's back sent flying off that exposed steel buckle. And now Darth Maul looking for a weapon, but Dr. Doom gonna shut that down here and throw Maul's head off the apron. But Darth Maul here, shot to the midsection. And now a scoop slam into a driver there on the outside here. And now gonna go back under the ring. And he's got a chair. And off the top of the head. So 2 weeks ago, Goku assaulted Dr. Doom with a steel chair. And now tonight, more of the same from the Universal Champion. But Dr. Doom here with a huge lariat. These two superstars might be moving up the ramp area here, but for right now, Darth Maul with that chair, but Dr. Doom somehow rolling out of the way, but then eating one to the top of the head once again. But then a knee smashing off of Darth Maul's face, and Dr. Doom not shy about how he feels in this matchup. But now Maul has brought that chair into the ring. Dr. Doom setting up for a suplex, a German suplex off of the steel chair. The back of Darth Maul's head bouncing off of that chair and a ducking lariat. And he's gonna go for a cover here. One, two. Kick out at two. That signature lariat we've seen Dr. Doom use so effectively. But will he need to hit a doomsday here tonight? Looks like he's setting up. Is this going to be it? Setting up for a doomsday. And he's got it. The challenger hits the doomsday on the champ. Do we have a new champion here tonight? One, two. Oh my God. Oh my God. And Dr. Doom is in disbelief here. Darth Maul powering out at the very last split second, hundredth of a second away from losing his Universal Championship, and a Sith kick out of nowhere! And a kick out! That Sith kick came out of nowhere so fast that I didn't even comprehend that it had happened. And here comes Maul. So after hitting a Sith kick, Dr. Doom powering out, drop salt there from Maul, and he's getting fired up here. Can the champion do it here? Can the champ retain his belt? Dr. Doom looking to get back in. Kicks Maul away. Now an Irish whip into the turnbuckle, but Maul with a counter and a Sith kick. Oh my God. One, two, and another kick out. And Darth Maul cannot believe it. Set up perfectly by that counter. But Dr. Doom has proven over the last 4 weeks that he is not an easy man to put away. How many Kamehamehas has he kicked out of over the last 4 weeks? And now kicking out of two Sith kicks. And it appeared he was going to go for that lariat, but Darth Maul read it perfectly and hit a clothesline of his own. And now the champ, gonna take a DDT here, and looks like Dr. Doom gonna go for a cover. Can he steal one here? One, two, kick out at two. What a match here tonight. Dr. Doom kicking back in that turnbuckle, trying to figure out here what he needs to do to walk out of Cincinnati with the Universal Championship. Looking for a German suplex, but that's countered by the champ. But right back into things with a huge maneuver. A swinging side slam, inverted swinging side slam there. And a Sith kick! A Sith kick from Maul. The third one, trifecta. One, two. I cannot believe this. I cannot believe what we are seeing here tonight. And Darth Maul here has got to be feeling extremely demoralized with his championship hanging in the balance. Ducking lariat there from Dr. Doom, but oh my God. One, two, kick out. Dr. Doom has proven once again that he is the hardest man on this roster to put away. Three Sith kicks from Darth Maul in this match. And some chair shots. Is that gonna do it? Kicked out again. Dr. Doom, the resiliency that this man possesses is unbelievable. What the hell does the champion have to do here to put away Dr. Doom in this matchup. And another cover attempt here from Maul. 2 hours out. If I'm Maul, I'm wondering right now if that sit kick's ever going to be enough. Another cover. 2. And another kick out. Clearly, Darth Maul very frustrated right now. Just looking to put Dr. Doom away. Feeling like he has done more than enough already to retain his championship, but Dr. Doom will not die. And now setting up for a huge DDT off of the turnbuckle. And Darth Maul is in a lot of trouble here. He is in a lot of trouble. Set up for a powerbomb. Thought he was going to go for a doomsday. Went for the powerbomb instead. He could have had Maul there. I think that he could have had Maul for sure. Maybe he thought that he couldn't get him up. I don't know what it was, but now going for a cover here. Do we have a new champion? 2. Kick out at 2. Unreal competition here tonight between these two. And now it appears that Dr. Doom is going to seek the aid of a tool here tonight. And it's going to be a ladder. What is he going to do with that ladder? But Maul not going to have it. Shot to the kidney. And now Darth Maul going to send him back into the ring here. Not going to worry about that ladder. He wants to stay away from that. It is set up on the outside, perched on the apron. Drop salt from Maul. Will that do it? 1, 2, kick out at 2. And Darth Maul, once again looking like he cannot believe what is happening here tonight. The challenger going for a sit kick and he misses. Oh my god, he missed. And now, Dr. Doom looking for a super kick, but Maul reads it, steps out of the way. Unbelievable matchup here tonight in our main event. Unbelievable. Both of these superstars cannot bear to think about not leaving here as champion. And now Darth Maul, after hitting another drop salt, might be setting up here. Looking for his 4th sit kick of the matchup. He's going to look for it. He's got it. Surely that's got to be enough. 1, 2, 3. What heart. What desire to win. What perseverance was shown here tonight by Dr. Doom. I have never seen anything like what we just saw here tonight. 4 Sith kicks it took to put Dr. Doom away. And Darth Maul, some resiliency of his own, powering out of that doomsday at 2 7/8. Knowing that his championship was that close to being gone. And then to come back over and over and over again with those Sith kicks. And then finally, the 4th time was the charm. And Darth Maul is leaving here still your Universal Champion. What a victory. What an event here at our first pay-per-view, Extreme Rules. Good night, everybody.